Well, welcome to another training video. Today we're going to go over how to change transfer belts. Now there's 7 belts on these little transfer 45 belt units. And today we're going to change out the long belt and the short belt over there. The long belt has lost its rib. And you can tell when they've lost a rib because they start developing these black marks on the top to show the center guide has fallen off. So with the transfer belt, we have 7 different sizes, and I'm going to go ahead and put this image on screen here. And this quick chart here on the side of the unit tells you what size belt you need in each position. So these are the tools you're going to need to change the transfer belt. You're going to need a 9/16 wrench, box knife, pair of needle nose pliers. This is a belt stretcher, and I'll show you how that works here in a minute. We use that to make changing out the belts quicker. So the belt stretcher we made right here in-house. And then you need, of course, your spare belts. In this case, for the long belt, we're using a 150.5. Okay, so you're gonna start by cutting the belt near the lacing. Go ahead and do that. Okay, then we gotta take and pull the pin out of the belt. Now you got your lacing ready, so you can lace in a new belt. So we're gonna use the old belt to pull the new belt in, but you see their lacing is different sizes. So this one has number 2 lacing on it, and this one comes with number 1 lacing. And so we're just gonna use another tool here. So here's our adapter piece. And all we have to do is lace this into the number 1 side, and this other side into the number 2 side, and I'll show you that now. Okay, that pin's in there. We'll get the number 2 pin lined up. And this only has to make it around one time, that's it. Okay. So now we've got the new belt laced to the old belt. We're gonna spread this one out a little bit. Then we'll use this belt, the old one, to pull the new one on in. Okay, our adapter and our pin have come back up with our lacing here. So we're gonna go ahead and take that off. And now we've got the new belt in place. Get the belt stretcher in place. Now that we clamp in one side of the belt stretcher here, okay, now that the belt stretcher is locked in place again, I'm just going to go ahead and tighten up the belt and bring the lacing together. You don't want to get the lacing too tight. That makes it hard to get the pin in, but just bring them together. And there's the pin, just like that. Go ahead and bend the end just a little. Pull it back. And there you go. We can take that belt stretcher off. And we can put this conveyor back in service immediately. And this is why we make the belt stretcher in two pieces on the bottom piece. Is because of that center guide. So when you go to take the belt stretcher apart, it's easy to slide out the sides. That's also why the belt stretcher is two-toned in color. So when you pull it all apart, the two colors are where you line it back up for proper alignment. Okay. So there is another way to adjust the tension on these belts if the belt's a little loose or too tight. And so you want to come underneath the unit to these rollers here and loosen these two bolts and then loosen this stop bolt down here, which will raise or lower your rollers. So your rollers put the tension on each individual belt. Okay, so we got two new belts on this unit. We've got the longest belt and the shortest belt have been changed out. And we're gonna pull off the e-stop and start the unit. And then we'll just check these belts to see if how tight they are or how they're running. It looks good for now, and that's all for this training video. Thank you.